Hey, I hope you're doing well. In this video, we will talk about selecting. Selecting and its potential to earn time, to change your life, and finally, be more happy. Yeah, I can imagine you are really impatient to know how to do, right? Because probably you ever said to yourself, I have too much things to do. Days are too short, or I'm interested in this activity, but I have not enough time. And you know, in most of the cases, the diagnostic is the same and pretty simple. You already have too much activities. Do you see the invitation to do nothing coming? Not exactly. It will be a little bit different. Because you know, faced with this situation, you may feel blocked. You may feel frustrated because this most of the time means that some activities you are interested in can't be included in your panel. And the most common reaction is to try to do more. I mean, you have your current activities and you will try to do it more fastly. But there is another alternative, more efficient in my opinion. It's reducing or eliminate some of your activities. Let's take a simple example. You live in a house and you want more space. What can you do? You can move the walls, you can build an extension, you can build a new house, for example, or you can remove some of your objects. What do you think? Which one will be the most efficient? Which one will require less energy? And this is the same for your panel of activities. For it, let's proceed in three steps. First one, identify your activities. Second one, imagine what you can do with these activities. Third one, act, test, and change. But just before starting to describe these three steps, I want to share with you a quote from Bill Gates, and I hope it will provide you a new window on the world. Do you see the trick? Do you see the funny trick? Window, Bill Gates' window on the world? Bill Gates so said, my success, part of it certainly, is that I focused in on few things. And I would invite you to think how focusing on few things may help you to earn time, to define better your priorities, and finally be more efficient, be more happy. To start, you can write a list, take a paper and just write a list of the activities you have per day, per week, and per month. Okay, and these activities just question roughly the time you dedicate to it. And then you can start to think about adjusting it. There are several possibilities. The first one, you can decide to remain it as it is. Or you can decide to change it. So you can increase, you can reduce the time you dedicate to it, you can choose to eliminate it, or you may subcontract it. And indeed, do not forget this possibility because it's an important lever to adjust these activities. You know, it's already what you do in your life. I guess you do not produce all the food you eat. You do not manufacture all the objects you have. So you can go further in this reflection and subcontract part of your activities. I really invite you to keep it in mind. To adjust these activities, what you can do is ask yourself the following questions. For example, take one of the activities which requires the most of time in your life and start to question it. To question also yourself. There is this activity. Ask yourself, what do you want to do with it? In which measure it's important to you? And see how does it sounds. Normally, you should have a feeling. Listen to this feeling. It should help you to define if you want to increase, reduce, eliminate, or remain this activity as it is. And pay attention to this feeling. Use your emotion to see which adjustment makes you more enthusiastic, makes you more happy. If you feel that reducing the time you dedicate to these activities makes you more happy, just act. Just try to reduce this activity. And this is the last step, and of course, the most important, just to act, to test how does it really goes for you when you try to experiment this. But just go step by step. It's not necessary to perform some kind of revolution, you know. Just identify one activity you want to adjust. Try to adjust it, for example, during 1 week, 2 weeks, see how does it goes. And then, if it's better, just keep it like this. And if it's not perfect, you can adjust it and also be back to the previous situation. To conclude, if you were interested by this video and enough curious to go further, I would invite you to check Minimalism Philosophy. And one book, if I have to recommend one book, I would say, you know, the book from Marie Kondo, the Japanese author, The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up. And with this book, you will notice by selecting your objects, you can also be more happy. That's all for today. I hope you will test and enjoy. See you.